गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ चार्जेस ऑन प्लेट्स। सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम टॉपिक एंड वी विल बेसिकली लर्न हाउ टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट चार्जेस ऑन टू डिफरेंट प्लेट्स एंड और मोर देन टू डिफरेंट प्लेट्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई टेक एनी क्वेश्चन ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ चार्जेस देन यू कैन से दैट suppose if we have a plate like this and some amount of charge is given to this plate. Suppose here we have two plates and to the first plate I have given 5 coulomb charge, and suppose to second plate I gave any amount of charge, like you can consider 3 coulomb of charge. Then if I ask you how much charge will come on these two surfaces Q1 or Q2, and how much charge will come to the surface Q3, and how much charge will come to the fourth surface, that is Q4, then you know that Q1 is nothing but 5 plus 3 summation of charges divided by 2, and it will be 4 coulomb. Here my answer will be of 4 coulomb, and you know this value is also equal to Q4, and Q4 charge I am giving to this particular place, that will be of 4 coulomb. And from 5 coulomb you have given 4 coulomb to this particular region, so remaining one is 1 coulomb. And here if you remember that formula by symmetry, here I should write minus 1, but let me check. If I have given minus 1, then you can say that minus 1 and plus 4 equal to plus 3, so plus 3 coulomb is distributed in Q3 and Q4. So this equation holds true that Q3 plus Q4 equal to this particular charge. Moreover, we have proved one more thing, that Q2 was difference of charges divided by 2. However, it is not required to remember this formula, but because we can directly solve from here only. If we have got Q1, then we know that this 5 coulomb is actually divided into Q1 and Q2. So Q1 is known 4 coulomb, so second Q2 should be 1 coulomb only. So from here also you can say Q1 is 5 minus Q2 is 3 and divide by 2. So you will get 2 by 2, that is 1 coulomb. And our answer is again 1 coulomb. So each formula is true in this case also. Now if I take another example, suppose in this rod I have taken 5 coulomb charge of positive 1 and here I have provided minus 3 coulomb charge. In that case also you have to apply the same formula, that is charge on this plate, let it be Q1, Q2 and Q3 and Q4. Then we know that our charge Q1 will be sum of charges and half of the summation, that is 5 minus 3, 2 by 2. So 1 coulomb charge will appear over here, and if from 5 you have subtracted 1, the remaining Q2 will be 4. We can understand, or you can apply Q2 equal to difference of charges divided by 2. So difference will be 5 and 3, 5 minus minus 3 divided by 2. You can understand 5 and this will become 8 by 2, and our answer will be 4. So here our answer should be 4. You can directly do in this manner also. Now remember one thing, that Q3 is always equal to Q2, inner side charge are always equal. Why these are equal? Because we have to maintain electric field at these point, at point Q and at P equal to 0. That's why this arrangement is like this. Okay. Moreover, you can go through previous lecture, and there you can understand how we have got this all these results. Okay, so Q3 will be how much? Q3 will be of negative of Q2, if you remember the derivation. So it is 4, so our answer here I will write minus 4. And what should I write for Q4? From minus 3 you have provided minus 4. Now what is the remaining one? Minus 3 minus minus 4, that is minus 3 plus 4, that is plus 1. So here I should provide plus 1 charge. My Q4 will be plus 1, because if you will add minus 4 coulomb and plus 1 coulomb, your answer will be minus 3. So this is called the exact distribution. Now let's move for the example in which we have more than two rod. Now in this case also you can understand, you can consider any value. Suppose I have considered 10, here I have given, you may take any value like minus 4, okay, minus 4, and then you can consider any number, even or odd, it's your choice. So suppose I have taken 6 coulomb charge over here, 6 coulomb charge I have provided to this rod, minus 4 coulomb to this rod and 10 coulomb to this rod. I want to know how much charge will appear on these surfaces where I have marked as a tick over here. So you can understand that at the corner or at the last ends, the charge here and here at these positions, the charge always we write, that is summation of charges 10 plus minus 4 plus 6 and divide by 2. This will be equal to how much? 6 minus 4, 2 and 12, I think 12 divided by 2, that is 6 coulomb. Okay, so here I will write 6 coulomb. So from 10 I have provided 6, so remaining one is 4. If here I have mentioned 4, then at this surface I should write minus 4. And from minus 4 I have provided minus 4 whole charge over here, so here I should write 0 coulomb of charge. If this is 0, then this is minus 0, because these are of opposite nature. By default it is 0, so you can say minus 0 and 0 both are equal. But in case if you don't have a negative 0, negative 5 or negative 4 is your answer suppose over here, then in that case you just have to, whatever is the answer instead of 0, you have to take negative of that value. Okay, so from 6 coulomb you have provided 0 coulomb, so what should be the remaining charge? That is 0. Ultimately your question is correct or your distribution is correct or not, how you will get to know? That is the simple one, that at the last surfaces, last corner, these charges should be equal. Okay, if you wish I can take one more example of more than one or two plates, like see here. I hope all these five rods are visible to you, first, second, third, fourth and five. Now you can consider any number of plate, okay, and you can give any number of charge. I have the simple process how to distribute charges. Okay, suppose you can consider any number, suppose I take 10, then minus 6, then I am just taking even numbers, you can take odd number also, just to take calculation easy one, and you can consider minus 4, you can consider okay, just consider plus 8 or any number, you can give 0 over here also. In case of 0 also you will distribute the charges in the same manner, or you can consider any number, just think okay, let it be minus 2. So what you have to do, the simple process is that suppose here my charge is q1 and at the last my charge is q2. Okay, I am trying to say that whatever charge will come to these two surfaces, how we write that charge? For that we have to write the simple one. You know that q1 and q2 means the first charge and the last charge are always equal, and all this is equal to what? Summation of all charges, 6, 10, minus 6, minus 4, plus 8, minus 2, and divide by 2 only, not divide by 5 if there are 5. This is not the average, just you have to divide it by 2. Then you can understand your answer will be 6 and 4, 10. This will be cancelled out, 8 minus 2, 6, 6 by 2 equal to 3. Means here you have to write 3, or let me take different color. Here your answer will be 3 coulomb charge, and here also you will write 3 coulomb charge, okay, plus 3, because these two values should be same. So think, if we have 10 coulomb charge over here, we have provided 3 coulomb charge here, how much is the remaining one? That is 7. And here on this portion I should write minus 7. Remember why I am writing all these values, because at any point, at these dotted point, these points, your electric field should be 0. To satisfy this condition only I am writing all these value in this particular manner. If you will write something else or any other charge, it is not possible that instead of minus 7 any other amount of charge will come over here. Why? Because if you will do so, then electric field at this point cannot be zero. You can calculate also, just go through that by the derivation. There I told you why this happens. So from minus 6, minus 7 is present over here. So how much I should write at this surface? That is plus 1. Now if you will add both the charges, you will get total charge minus 6. If you have written plus 1 over here, then here you will write minus 1. And from minus 4, I have taken minus 1 over here. So remaining is minus 3. Okay. Only then minus 3 and minus 1 equal to minus 4. Now if it is minus 3, then you can say this side I should write plus 3. If it is plus 3, then from 8 we subtract 3, we will get plus 5. Now if it is plus 5, then here I will write minus 5. Now from minus 2, I have written minus 5 over here. So here I should write plus 3. So that plus 3 and minus 5 will become together minus 2. And by formula also here I should write plus 3. Okay, next topic you can see that is dielectric. Okay, now we have to understand some basic properties of dielectric. Basically, on theoretical basis you can say that dielectric are of two type, non-polar and polar. Here we will talk about some basic properties of dielectric material. So try to understand what are its basic properties. So as you can see, I have made two diagram. Diagram number one is for metal, okay, and diagram number two is for dielectric. Basically this black rectangle shows your metal at this place, and this the same black rectangle here is showing the dielectric material. Okay, now try to understand. Suppose if I have provided this external electric field, as you can see this E external is provided over here, and this external electric field, this may be due to some source. Okay, and if I talk about this source, what can be the source by which we are getting our electric field in such form? Okay, by observing these lines, these red lines, you can see that your electric field is constant. Why? Because this particular gap, okay, the gap over here, suppose this is 5 centimeter, then at this point also, this dot dot point, this gap is again 5 centimeter, means whatever is the length of this gap, this gap also will have the same length. So to produce the constant electric field, the possible source may be an infinite plate. Okay, and you have learned all these things, that due to infinite plate only this is possible, that we can produce a constant amount of electric field. So for now we are just concerned with only this particular situations. Okay, in case of metal, if we talk first, in case of metal there are many electrons present inside a metal. Again, just keep in mind that electrons are present in metal. This doesn't mean that your metal is having negative charge. Okay, that means that these electrons are available in outer subshell of the metal, that is D subshell. Okay, or it may be in F subshell also, but these are valence electron basically. Okay, and on the upper surface we are trying to show only valence electron. So what happens due to this external electric field, this electron will experience some amount of force, and you know that force is QE, and direction of this force is opposite to the electric field. Why? Because this is negative charge. So what will happen as a result, your electron will gather on the left hand side, because we have many number of electron, so all negative charge will try to shift, or you can say all valence electron will try to shift to the left hand side. So from where this electron is coming, actually this electron is coming basically from some atom. Okay, so whenever any electron leaves the surface of any atom, what we get over there, we get some positive ion. Okay, and this positive ion will behave like a positive charge. Actually it is a positive charge, and this positive charge will experience a force in direction of electric field. So as a result, at the right hand side, your positive charge will gather. So what will happen? Due to this positive and negative charge, an induced electric field will set up in this direction, because electric field is away from positive charge and towards the negative charge. Remember, this black electric field, I can say these lines are due to this induced charge. Okay, so I will call it E induced. So in metal, basically we have many numbers of electron. Those electron will try to shift towards left, and finally one situation will create such that E induced will become E external. Okay, in that case we call that inside metal net electric field is zero. Similarly, if we talk about dielectric material, we know that inside dielectric material, electrons, you can consider like electrons are available, but that many numbers of electrons are not available as in case of metal, you can say. Okay, very few number of electrons are available. For now, just think in mind that we have limited number of electrons. For example, we have only 3 electrons. Then what will happen? These 3 electrons will gather towards the left. Okay, and the positive ion that will be formed when this electron will leave the surface of any atom. Okay, that positive ion will come towards right under the influence of this force, because positive charge experience a force in direction of electric field, and negative charge experience a force opposite direction of electric field. Okay, this force. So basically all positive charge will gather towards this side. Okay, but in this case, as I told you, that this induced electric field doesn't have that much value. Okay, it is not equal to E external. In fact, it is very very less than E external, because we have limited number of electron. Remember, E induced will only increase if we have more amount of negative charge at this place. Okay, so what happens in this case, that E induced is less than E external. So net electric field inside a dielectric, we can say that is not equal to zero. In fact, it is equal to E external minus E induced. Now here I will talk about something that is called dielectric constant. Dielectric constant, it is denoted by K. Now try to understand what is dielectric constant. To understand this dielectric constant, I am just taking a simple value of E external. Let I should take 100. 100 is my E external, and E induced is 50. For example, just take E induced equal to 50. Means 50 is the opposition and 100 is the E external. 100 is E external. So if I ask you that what is my dielectric constant, or just forget dielectric constant for a while. If I just ask E net is how much? What is the net electric field inside this material? Okay, you will say E net is E external, that is total external factor, minus you will say opposite the factor which is opposing it, that is E induced. Means E external is 100 and in opposite direction E induced is 50. Okay, so remaining is our 50. 50 is the net electric field. So I am telling you that to get E net, what we do, we take E external, okay, and we divide it by some number. We divide it by some number, SOME, this is some number, okay, some mathematical number. That mathematical number will be called K. So I am just asking a simple question, okay, like E external is 100. I want to divide 100 by some number. What should be that number so that I will get my answer E net equal to 50? By which factor I should divide 100 so that I can get my E net 50? Then you will say that number is 2. So I am saying that number is nothing, but that is called dielectric constant. Okay, I hope you understood the meaning of dielectric constant. Basically, in books, it is written that it is the ratio of external electric field to net electric field. That is, external is 100 and net is how much? 50. If you will divide 100 by 50, then you will get 2, and that 2 is my dielectric constant. Or simple language, I can say that if for any material your dielectric constant is given, that is 100, okay, and for that particular material, suppose your external applied field E external is nothing but suppose 240 Newton per coulomb. This much electric field is applied on a particular material, dielectric material, okay, and for that dielectric material K is 80. So what does this K tells us? Okay, this tells us that inside dielectric, the net electric field that will experience, that will be lesser than 240, and how much is it? That is E external divided by K. Okay, that means 240 divided by 80, you will get 3 as an answer. So net electric field you will get in this material, that is 3 only. And for water, we have dielectric constant this much. Okay, remember. So in case of water, this is water. If you apply net electric field 240, then for water, your net electric field experience by only 3. Okay, by this much factor, water reduces electric field. So this is again called definition of dielectric constant. For example, if I take that for any other material, for a particular material that is called mica, and that is a mineral basically. Suppose if your dielectric constant is K only, 6 only, that is property of material. For this, dielectric constant is, predefined, that is 6. So if someone says that I have taken mica and I have some external electric field that is again 240, then how much electric, suppose here we have any person that is sitting in, is inside this room or inside this mica cavity, okay, then if someone is asking that how much electric field this person will experience, this person will feel, how much electric field, okay, is it possible that this person will experience the same amount of electric shock or some lesser amount of electric field this will experience? So definitely this will going to experience a lesser amount of electric field, and the net electric field for this person will be 240, the external electric field divided by 6. Okay, so 40, only 40 Newton per coulomb of electric field will be experienced by this material. Okay, so this is the meaning of K only. So if any material has greater dielectric constant, that means that material will get only lesser amount of magnitude, lesser amount of magnitude of electric field. And if any material has very less amount of dielectric constant, that means that material will experience a greater amount of electric field compared to the previous one. Okay, for example, if I say for a particular material, we have very special material, okay, and for that material is, if dielectric constant is very very large number, very large, that is infinite up to, and suppose if you are providing any number, any amount of electric field, suppose E external is 100, then how much electric field this material will experience? We will say the electric field experienced by this material is E external divided by K, and remember K is always greater than 1 for every material. Okay, so for air and vacuum it is 1, and for other material it is greater than 1. So you will say your answer will be 100 divided by infinity, that means 0. And remember, this material is what? This is metal. For metal, dielectric constant is defined as infinity. So dielectric constant is nothing but just a mathematical number to get E net. The real thing is that E induced, okay, and E induced occurs due to motion of charges.